Today I have this Peterbilt 579. I'm going to be showing you how to replace the batteries. The reason why I'm going to be replacing the batteries is because it's sending this message. The low voltage disconnect. This is an issue that happens to all Packard trucks, Kenworths, and Peterbilts. They have a system that disconnects all the power from the truck when the voltage goes below than 12 volts. So it disconnects everything from the truck to prevent any excessive battery discharge to allow starting to the truck. Because if the battery goes completely dead, you won't be able to start the engine. So this system does that. So if you see this message coming on your screen of your Packard truck, KW or Peterbilt, that means then you will need to replace your batteries. So the batteries are located in here in this compartment. This fairing has this access door over here for the batteries. You can have access to the batteries to have a quick look, or you can replace them from here. But I will recommend you to remove the whole panel because it's easier. Just removing these 6 bolts. They are 17 millimeters. There is 3 in this aluminum plate, and there is another 3 in this other aluminum plate. With the fairing completely removed, we have access to the batteries, and now we have more room to work around to remove the batteries. So the first thing we have to do to remove the batteries is to disconnect the negative poles, the negative cables. So we are going to be using an I-16 to remove the nuts that holds the battery cables on place. So there are 4 in total. With all the nuts completely removed, we can easily remove all the negative cables from the batteries. Just remember to reinstall it in the same position. After removing the negative cables from the batteries, we're going to remove the positive ones. So we're gonna do the same, we're gonna remove the nuts, then hold the batteries cables on place. We're gonna remove the 4 of them, and then we're gonna remove the cables. Just remember the position of each cable because you're going to reinstall it in the same position. All the battery cables are completely removed. Make sure to put them in a safe position, a safe location, so they don't interfere on your way when you are removing the batteries. In this case, this truck has this orifice over here, so I put them over there. But if the truck doesn't have any orifice, you can get a zip tie and tie it over here somewhere to keep the cables away from the batteries, so you have a easy, you have more room to an easier access to the batteries when you're removing them. So the next step is to remove this bracket. This is the battery support, the one that keeps the batteries in place. We're gonna be using a 13 millimeter or a 1/2 inch socket to remove these supports over here, these bars. Okay, after removing the bars that hold the bracket, we can easily remove it. And I have the bars right here. And you can see this is the way they look like. So the next step is to pull the batteries out. When I get my hand here, I'm gonna get it up. And once it gets up, I'm gonna pull it out. I'm gonna repeat the same process with all the 4 batteries. So I have the 4 batteries out. They look okay, they don't seem like they have any damage. But I was looking at this one, this specific one. You can see it has like a damage over it. So this damage can be the reason why the batteries are getting bad. So now if you are installing new batteries, make sure to don't buy the same type of batteries. As you can see, these are starting batteries. Don't buy these batteries for your Peterbilt 579 or any Peterbilt model, KW model, Cascadias. All those trucks, they require deep cycle batteries to feed all the electric system, all the electronic components that are in the cab. Because in this case, this specific truck has a fridge and a power inverter. So this battery needs to supply all those components. And the starting battery is not capable to do that. So in this case, we're gonna be installing deep cycle batteries, which are these ones over here. These batteries are meant to retain the power for a while, for like more around 24 hours. They won't be able to hold the power for like 2 days, 3 days, but at least 24 hours without starting the truck. And they will be able to start the truck back with no problem. So if you are replacing your batteries on your Peterbilt, KW, Cascade, Volvos, or Internationals, make sure to install the dual cycle, deep cycle, or dual purpose batteries, because they are better on those trucks, especially if they have a fridge or a power inverter. So the first thing before starting the batteries is to mark the year on this label over here. You see this label, so when I mark the month and the year, this is only for warranty purposes, because it's easier when you know when this battery was installed. So when you go and claim a warranty, you know when this battery was installed. So I'm gonna do that with all the batteries. The first thing you're gonna notice about these deep cycle batteries is that they're heavier than the regular starting batteries. They're around 15 to 20 pounds heavier, so it will be more difficult to put them in the battery compartment. So you will need to find a way how to put them over there nicely without hurting yourself. Remember, when you are about to install the batteries, remember to install them in the same position. So I know the positive cable goes to the back like that, so remember to put it in the same position. Pretty much all the trucks are going to be the same, except for some applications that they can have a different type of battery compartment, and the positive and negative could be in a different position. So make sure to remember that. So now I'm going to install all the 4 batteries in the battery compartment one by one with the batteries on place. The first thing I'm going to do is to place this bar, the one that goes in between right here. I had to introduce this bar from underneath, right there. You can see the orifice right there. So I'm going to introduce the bar right there. It's kind of difficult, so you gotta find its way there. And you gotta hold it right there, you see? This is where it holds. So I'm gonna hold it with this hand over here, and then I'm going to install this bracket. And I'm going to install the nut on top. And then after that, I'm going to install the other two, then go over here on the side. There's one bar over here and another bar over here too. So I'm gonna install the 3 of them, and then I'm gonna tie the bracket to secure the batteries before putting any cables. Okay, the batteries are on position. They're tied with this bracket. Now the next step will be to install all the positive cables. So we're gonna check for corrosion on the cables like this. If you find any corrosion like this, clean it before installing the cables. So we're gonna check for all the other positive cables for corrosion, and if they have any, we're gonna clean them, and then we're going to install them. Remember to install them in the same position. As after installing all the positive cables, double check they are in the proper position. Make sure they are installed in the proper position all the time. Double check, that's very important. Now I'm going to install all these cable bridges on the negative post side of the batteries. I'm gonna install the 3 of them with all the negative bridges, cable bridges on position. I'm going to install the main negative cable, which is this one over here. So I'm gonna put it on place. I wanna see if it sparks. Amount of spark is normal. If you see a big spark coming on from the batteries, that means there's something wrong with the batteries. A cable is not properly installed in a proper position, or the battery is damaged, or something is going on with the cable. So make sure then whenever you are installing the cable, test it before installing it completely, otherwise the truck can catch on fire and that would be a big problem. So now knowing that everything is alright, I'm going to install all the nuts and the other cables back on place. I'm going to tie them. Okay, all the battery cables are installed. Double check the cables double check the position of the cables, make sure that everything is in the proper position. Now I'm going to install the bearing, the steps back on place, but before doing that I'm going to make sure that everything on the cap is working. You see the lights and the screen is working, that means then the system is back online. So I'm going to put the fairing, the steps back on place, and then I'm going to start the engine. So the first thing you gotta check once you start the engine is the battery voltage. In this case, this truck doesn't have a battery voltage meter. Also, the screen over here doesn't have a battery voltage meter. So, in this case, it will be hard to know the voltage that is getting to the batteries. In this case, because right now we don't have a battery meter. But anyway, you can get a voltmeter, you know, like a multi-tester, and just put it on the batteries and check the battery voltage. It should be around 13.5 to 14.1. That will be a good battery voltage. In this case, I know that the battery is working with no problems, because, I mean, the alternator is working with no problems in charging the batteries, because there is no message saying that the battery voltage is low. Other than that, it will be showing that. But I will recommend to do that, to actually physically test the battery voltage with a voltmeter or with a multi-tester, whatever you have in hand, just to know the battery voltage. It is just because this truck doesn't have the battery voltage meter. In other trucks, other Peterbilts or KWs, they have battery voltage meter, so it's easier. But in this case, we have to physically inspect that. Now, with the engine off, all you gotta check is for the message. Now the message is gone. As you can see, there is no message about battery volts low. If you still getting that message, that means then there is something wrong with the modules that control the battery voltage in the truck. So that'd be all I'm going to be showing you about the battery replacements on this Peterbilt 579. As I said before, the battery replacements are going to be very similar to many different Peterbilt models. It may vary depending on the components you have to remove to get access to the batteries, but it's going to be very similar. If you want to send some support or donation to my channel, you can check the video description below for details, so I can continue making videos like this to help everybody on the road, mechanics, technicians, or anybody that works on their own trucks, or people that have their own business doing repairs on their trucks. If you have any questions about this video, just comment below. If you have anything to add, any comments, any suggestions, you can comment below, like, share, subscribe, and thank you for watching.